Hi everyone, my name is Maxime Chagnot. I'm a CATIA consultant working for PLM technology in Norway. And today it's a special episode called Design Fast. It's the number 4. It's similar to a tutorial where I'm going to demonstrate how to make a pipe in CATIA. So to start, we are going to make a physical product called flexible pipe assembly. As you can see, I'm in assembly design. I will now insert a 3D part called fixed socket, and we will switch on part design by double clicking on 3D shape, and we will just make a pipe socket. So the shape does not really matter here, and I'm not going to put any constraints. It's just for the video to show you how we can make the pipe using surface design. Okay, we can make something similar to that. I don't need any constraint here, but I can just be sure that we are talking about the same diameter in both pipes. So let's say 20, it's pretty big, but okay. I will make now a shaft using the Y axis. I can also use the horizontal axis, but I prefer to use the Y directly. It's a bit more robust. Great. As you can see, the pipe has been designed. It's a socket. And we can see that we have the Y axis here. What I will add in my design is a point here and a line. And to do so, I'm going to insert a geometrical set in my 3D shape. Just by clicking on a 3D shape, you have a small menu here that appears. Geometrical set, okay, number 2, it does not matter which number it is. And I will make a point in the middle of the circle. And I will add a line with the option point direction. Point is this one, and the direction is, of course, the Y axis. I can also reverse the direction, and we can enlarge a bit this line up to this area here. I will just colorize my point and my line, so then we can see it a bit better. I will just change the cross by a square and put it in pink. Same for the line, I will change it to pink. Okay, we just did the fixed part. I will now hide the plane because I don't need them. I go back to my assembly and I will fix my socket in the engineering connection definition panel. Okay, now we know that this part is fixed. We cannot move it with the robot. I will now insert another 3D part called moving socket. It's going to be very similar to the one we made. These are on the same position, so I will just hide the fixed socket now. So in that case here, we are going to make exactly the same or similar. We can change a bit the design. Same on the design here does not matter, and I'm not going to put any constraint except the external diameter, just to be sure that it's the same everywhere. Okay, so if you're not sure that this one is there, you can also make a line and say that this line is a construction element, and you can constrain this point here to the line. Okay, we exit the sketch now and we'll make a shaft. I can of course select the Y axis like I did before, insert Y axis, and now you have your shaft and we have our socket. I will do exactly the same with the previous part. I will insert a point. I've been a bit too fast. I will make it in the geometrical set here. I will insert the point in the middle of the circle here, as you can see, and do the same with the line from the point that we created and the direction Y. Same, we will reverse the direction, and you can just make sure that the line is over this area here. Great. Now I can just colorize my point to green, for example. And same for the line. Green here. Okay, so far so good. I will also hide the tree plane here. I go back to my assembly and I will, as you can see, both of the socket are on the same area. So I will just move the socket here by drag and dropping the robot to my part, and just by using the tree direction, move until I get something nice. Yeah. Why not like that? I want to complete different from the fixed one. As you can see, it's different. We can also change the height. Okay. It's different height, different orientation, and it's in 3D. So what to do now? We will make the flexible pipe. I will go back to my assembly design by double clicking, insert a 3D part that we will call flexible pipe. Okay, this pipe arrives in the middle of my assembly. There is no problem for that. And I will switch to the part design here, to the part level, but actually I'm not going to use part design. I'm going to use generative shape design for making a nice surface. And for doing that, I will insert the geometrical set. Okay, where I will connect these two point and line with a spline, and that will give us the guide for our pipe later on. You have the feature spline here that asks you to have a point and a direction. So I will just select the point here, and I receive an error message, or not an error message, but just an alert saying that this is another path, so you will keep the link with the object. And of course, this is what I want. I select the line. I will receive this message several times. No problem. I just want to be sure that you have a curvature connection. Okay. And I will continue by selecting the other one. Yes. As you can see, we have a 3D curve, but I don't like this orientation. So I will just click on the option reverse tangent. And here again, I want a curvature continuity. If you want to change a bit the shape of this curve, you can also move or change the tension. But I would say that keep 1-1 for the beginning and improve it after, because tension can also change very much the shape of your pipe after. Okay, so I have my 3D curve now, but this is three disconnected elements. So I will just make a join between the line here, the spline, and the line. And now we have the guide curve we need. I will also hide the point because we don't need them. Like that, okay. And I will use the feature sweep with the option, it's number 3 here, center and radius. And we know that the radius is actually 20. No problem, I can just select the join here. Preview, and now we can see that the pipe has been created in 3D and it follows the curve between the two parts. I click on OK, but as you can see here, this is still a surface, and what we want is a body, a solid, let's say. So I will just hide my joint here and define in work object the part body, switch to part design, and select the option thick surface. Okay, and you can see that I want 1 millimeter thick pipe, no problem. I can hide my geometrical set. I can also hide all the geometrical sets in all of my parts. Hide and hide. And if I change the color, I will put a transparent purple. Okay, and what we can now do is to move this part here, the fixed part. I don't know if you noticed, but we have a small link now, a small thumb that is active. It's red because, of course, we need to update our assembly. Now we have a diamond, a green diamond. It means that the part is up to date. Okay, I can even change the rendering. Great. And I will now move this part by drag and dropping the robot. Okay, this is exactly what we did before. And you want to move the orientation, you want to change the height, you want to change the direction in that way. No problem. Just move your parts. And that's great if you have two parts that are actually moving between each other. Between, for example, a tank and an engine. And I do update and look. Here, my pipe has been updated according to my spline. And of course, now you can add more points, more anchor to this assembly. You can change the tension of the pipe if you want to. Just to show you that it's possible to make kind of a pipe using surface design in CATIA. So thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope you will watch more of them. And please don't hesitate to contact us and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye.